Hey everybody, this is Dr. Michael Scherer. In this training video, we're going to talk about how we go ahead and we seal the top of our locator angled abutment. Now, understand too, up to this point with our traditional locator abutments, we've advised that you do not want to go ahead and put anything on the inside of your traditional locator abutments, the one with the little triangle, the gold in the triangle. Now, with our locator angled abutments, we do advise that you do need to go ahead and seal the top of the little channel of your locator angled abutments. And what we're going to go ahead and we're going to do is we're going to seal and protect the little retaining screw with a PTFE or a cotton pellet, and then seal with a composite resin over the top, so then that way it keeps everything nice, hygienic, as well as sealed on the inside of the abutment. Very similar to like what you would do for your traditional custom abutment or your implant retained crowns. That strategy, we will apply it to locator angled. I've got my setup right in front of me here. What I've got in front of us is I have my educational model with my implant that have the 15 degree angles in the posterior, and we've just recently placed our two traditional locators in the front and our two angled locators in the posterior. Additionally, I have my my crown delivery kit for my clinical practice, which also includes a pair of iris scissors, a little small condenser or plugger, so then that way we can also go ahead and put everything together. And also, I've got some composite material and a curing light. So in front of us here, I've got some Bulk Easy Plus material, as well as my curing light to go ahead and finish up the procedure. Let's go ahead and dive right in. In front of us here, we have our educational model here with my recently placed locator abutments and my locator angled abutments. Here also, I've got my Bulk Easy Plus material, and then I've also got some PTFE little pellets. Now, it doesn't need to be PTFE, it could be something else. It could be cotton pellets or something similar. But we do want to place something that is very flexible over the top of the retaining screw prior to placing my composite. Additionally, I have my crown seat kit for my clinical practice. As I open this up, inside of here, I've got a pickup cotton plier here. I've got a small condenser, and then I've also got kind of like a spoon excavator, as well as a hemostat, a small scaler, and then usually like a plastic instrument or just a little spatula to go ahead and smooth off the composite, as well as articulating paper. And then I do like these footballs, just so then that way I've got a football condenser as well as just a ball condenser on the other end. And then also I do like to go ahead and have here just a small spatula in case I needed to mix anything or do whatnot. Generally, I don't need that for locator angle. This is my universal implant crown delivery kit. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that to the side. And what I'm gonna do here now is I need to grab my cotton pickup, and I'm going to grab out one of these pellets. Now, before we do this, we want to make sure that we've torqued our locator angled abutments down. Okay, so you have to torque that. Prior to torquing, take a radiograph to confirm full adaptation of your implant. Now, I'm going to grab one of these very small pellets. Now, you can see how tiny this thing is here. Now, what happens is that the tendency is to go ahead and use a very large PTFE pellet. I encourage you just use a very, very tiny one, because then I can always add two to it if I needed to. So as I take this, we're going to air dry the inside of my locator angled abutment. So you grab an air water syringe and just have your assistant or blast away. Just make sure there's no moisture inside of there. Then I make sure I still have my throat pack in place. I'm going to go ahead and take my PTFE material on the top of my locator angled abutment. And then I'm going to take my small condenser and just barely just kind of tap it down. And I kind of just gently spread it out a little bit, making sure that I cover that screw completely. Okay, so now this scenario here, I may want to use one more pellet because I can see a small portion of the lingual portion of the screw still exposed. So I'll grab one more very small pellet, drop it in there, and then take a condenser and pop it in. Oh, that's much better. Perfect. Okay, now that looks like it's properly sealed. Now you have the option, we can go ahead and do both abutments at the same time, which is what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the other side, pop that in, just kind of tamp it down, and I can use even just like the tip of my cotton pellet, give this just a little tamp down, and that looks like I got it pretty good here with just that one pellet. So I'm going to put that instrument to the side. Now, before I place my composite resin, we do not need to go ahead and etch or bond for our locator angled abutment. And then also, I don't need to do anything like put any mechanical retention or anything on the inside of my locator angled little cylindrical channel. I place the cotton pellet or PTFE plug over the top of the screw. The abutment has been torqued, pellet goes in, and then composite resin goes over the top. So now I'm going to go ahead and take out my bulk easy material, and I'm going to just verify that that material starts to flow out. So I've got an old tip here. I'm just going to place a little bit right on there, make sure it strings out. Now this material is really ideal for this application because it's so easy for this to flow. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to place this tip just on the inside of my locator angled abutment and just give it a little bit of pressure. And I'm going to pull it back as I fill it up. The key here, everybody, is do not overfill your locator angle. The reason why I like this bulk filled material is because it's very simple for me to go ahead and grab my little plastic instrument and just kind of pull that material or just take my finger, just dab it, and then it just flows right into place. If I'm going to err on the side of either slightly overfilling or slightly underfilling, I would much rather err on the side of slightly underfilling. Take that into my other one. Pull back a little bit and then watch it just kind of fall into place. Grab my little plastic instrument and take a finger swipe and just barely touch it. So now my finger, I don't want to do a pokey finger. It's a wide finger. So I just go like that straight across. Now, once I placed my Bulk EZ Plus material onto my locator angled abutment, I want to go ahead and let the Bulk EZ Plus kind of rest for approximately 90 seconds prior to light curing to ensure that the material has had a chance to go ahead and seal all the crevices and flow to the areas so that way you get a really good seal around your locator angled abutment. Once my Bulk EZ materials had a chance to go ahead and set and settle, I'm now going to go ahead and light cure to go ahead and finish the curing process. Now that my curing light is finished, I now have everything properly sealed. Notice here that I've got my locator angled abutments with my Bulk EZ Plus material covering the posterior implants and nothing covering these anterior two, since these are the standard locators and these back here are my locator angled. Now, it's also a really good idea to go ahead and double check that you have not overfilled the top of your locator angled abutment with composite. One really good way to do that is to go ahead and take a housing for either your removable or your locator fixed case and snap it on top of your locator angled abutment to confirm that it goes down all the way. Additionally, if you don't want to use your housings, you can also use an impression coping to go ahead and pop it on there to verify that it snaps on. If it doesn't feel like you've got an audible snap or it doesn't pop on there really well, you may want to check that you have not overfilled. If you've overfilled, you do have to go ahead and take a polishing instrument and polish that down. So then that way you can verify that your future locator or locator fixed housing and insert can snap on properly. I'll demonstrate here now. In front of us here, we have our finished case with our sealed locator angles in the back and our locator removal in the front. And I can go ahead and take my locator fixed housing right here, which is the gold one, or my locator removable housing, or my impression coping to go ahead and try that on here for my angle. So I'll take my fixed housing on one side. I'll take that and just pop it on. And you'll hear that good snap. And then right here, pop that on. Feels great. And then you can also demonstrate here by using your locator impression coping, and you'll hear that little snap as it goes on there as well. Now, ultimately, you won't always necessarily hear or feel that snap, but you do want to go ahead and give it a gentle little tug to make sure it engages properly. As mentioned, if I'm going to err on the side of either slightly overfilling or slightly underfilling my locator angled fill or seal, I want to go ahead and slightly underfill, just slightly, everybody. Now, it's important that we do keep that sealed because that'll help keep everything fresh on the inside of the abutment. As part of routine maintenance for my locator angled cases, I do want to go ahead as part of my hygiene protocol, have my hygienist inspect that composite seal is still intact. If it is not, I need to go ahead and remove what's in there, flush it out, clean it out, use a little bit of medicament cleaner like a Consepsis or a 2% chlorhexidine, clean the inside of my abutment, air dry it, and then reseal it during when the patient comes back for hygiene recalls. Everybody, this is Dr. Michael Scherer with another training video here for Locator Angled.